Hello everyone, my name is Joost Rozenkrans. I'm a designer and a design educator, and I'm active in the design business for over 30 years now. I'm from the Netherlands, a small country in the northwest of Europe with Amsterdam as a capital. I live and work in The Hague, a coastal city and the third city of the country. The Hague has the biggest collection of works by the famous Dutch painter Piet Mondriaan. And actually the Dutch have a very rich visual history that all started in the 17th century with oil painting by painters with names such as Rembrandt and Vermeer. Vermeer is the painter of the girl with the pearl earring. A substantial part of the country is below the sea level and reclaimed from the sea. We have windmills, dams and dikes and other waterworks to keep Holland dry and protected, because about one third of the country is below sea level. So you could say that a big part of Holland is man-made and actually designed. Now, I worked in Holland for 18 years altogether, and also lived and worked in the UK for 2 years and 10 years in China. China is an amazing culture, very visual, and a lot happens on the streets. Extreme contrast between old and new, and also between rich and poor. And everything is fast moving with fantastic food. It's a country of enormous scale and big numbers. I worked for 9 different design studios, long time for Studio Dunbar, and for 1 newspaper, the Guardian newspaper in London, 4 universities in total, 3 in the Netherlands and 1 in China. I also founded 2 design studios. That was NLXL in the Netherlands in 2001. And in 2012, Sparky Tiger in Shanghai together with a Chinese designer. My first project out of art school was designing the logo for the Dutch National Police Force, after winning a design competition between 3 Dutch design studios and a merger of the national and regional police in the early 90s. This was at Studio Dunbar, now 30 years ago, and still in use. Striping on cars, boats, helicopters and other vehicles is an important part of the visual identity. It guarantees optimized visibility during day and night. And with front doors opened, every car can become a visual roadblock for emergency situations. This way, cars become a safety tool for police officers. In my view, the ability to come up with ideas will be the important skill for designers to stay relevant in the future. Next to doing other things like research and critical thinking. Design production skills will get more and more automated in the years to come. We see that happening already. For instance, in China, where internet giant Alibaba is developing Luban. It's an AI system that is designing 15 million banners per day, and they are all based on the content, form and structure of individualized data by single users, and it's also delivered at the best moment of day for that particular person. So having that in mind and seeing where the developments are going to, I think ideation has to become a very important part of design education. It's something you can learn, I'm convinced about. Talent helps, of course, but I have developed 6 mindsets to create visual ideas with. I've written a book about design, and a substantial part of the book is about design ideation. The title is How to Create Better Ideas, Connecting the Left and Right Brain in the Design Process. It's a design theory book, or an educational book, with many visuals and infographics, and it's published by Bisch Publishers in Amsterdam. The book divides in 2 parts, the left brain explaining the design process as a total, and part 2 is about ideation, the creation of better visual ideas. Next to a good design process and ideation, the book also shares many other insights. For instance, how to create value, what effective design mentalities are, and helpful habits and conditions for designers. Now, what exactly is a good design idea? It's the part of the design process after doing research and writing a brief. So when the problem and the ambition are defined, and the part before fine-tuning and detailing the design. I define 4 criteria for good design ideas. First of all, they have to be original, that means unique with a sense of surprise. Also, ideas have to be relevant, serving a useful purpose. Thirdly, an idea has to be urgent. That means it's vital and needed right now. So this is about timing. And four is they have to be valuable, and that can be economic, social, or environmental value. I'm curious how you develop ideas. Do you have any particular ways of working or thinking? If I ask designers how they do it, they generally give me two answers. First of all, they say when I'm inspired, or when we are in a brainstorm. To me, any way of creating ideas is fine as long as they give good results. Now, I have developed 6 effective mindsets to create ideas with. Mindsets that can be learned by practicing, for instance, to think like a scrapyard worker. This book was made this way. It's by a Dutch artist, Paul Bogaars, and he composed a book with existing sentences, complete sentences taken from 250 existing books, just by cutting and pasting them and using them at their original typeface. As you can see in the image, quite an exciting idea, I think. Being able to create ideas is a talent, but it can also be learned and developed, like training a muscle when you do exercise. You can learn to think like a visual magnet, which is about making unexpected connections. The striping of the Dutch police cars, as mentioned earlier, was made with a mindset of an unexpected connection. So it's a combination of any white car model connecting with this traffic sign with diagonals on it, with the ambition to make the police cars into driving traffic signs. Mindsets enable you to develop ideas faster and more diverse, under time pressure or when more ideas are needed. So you can learn to think like a mental chameleon, for instance, or like Madonna and Ali G in One Body, which is actually about provocation. The other part of the book is predominantly about the design process, what steps to make in what order. The left side of the brain and the analytical quality of the brain. I made a model that I call the snake, and it is about how to create options and how to make choices. It's an infographic that explains how to do good research, to get to conclusions, write a design brief with ambition included, how to create ideas, then how to fine-tune ideas and deliver the end results. And all these steps are also explained more in depth. Idea creation is placed in the center of the snake infographic. This is an example of a strong idea. It's Precious Plastic, an open source plastic recycling project with a community of over 40,000 participants around the world. They share blueprints of small-scale machines to produce and process plastic with, also coding and source materials. And it makes recycling of plastic possible locally and on a small scale. An idea that is both relevant, urgent, valuable, and original. A project by Dave Hakkens from the Netherlands. Now, a good design process is not a guarantee to get to exciting results. It always needs full dedication. But it can give structure and help you to find if any vital parts are missing, if a design project doesn't work out the way you expected. The book also talks about design habits and mentality, and about the purposes of design, meaning all forms of applied arts. There are 4 purposes. Design is there for communication, to bring a message or tell a story, and for identification, that means adding personality to organizations, products, services, or places. Design can be about function, designing tools or guiding systems for physical or digital spaces, or about construction, creating three-dimensional experiences. The book also explains the differences between imagination, creativity, and innovation. Now, who will find this publication interesting? I think the book is relevant for students and young designers, and for experienced designers of all design disciplines. And particularly the ideation part will be interesting for design professionals as well. It's recommended by Professor Wang Min, former dean of the best art school in China, called CAFA, and he was also the design director of the 2008 Beijing Olympics, and by Dutch design critic and curator Toon Louwe, writer of 14 international books about design and architecture. and publisher of What magazine, Wonderful Things magazine. The book is available via the website of bishpublishers.com and on bookselling platforms around the world. And I give lectures and workshops based on the content of the book. Goodbye, everyone. Greetings from the Netherlands and enjoy the conference.